Most of people agree something needs to be done to protect our kids from online harm. And today, the government is promising action. But will a blanket social media ban keep them any safer?
It's not easy. We accept that. And the result mightn't be perfect, but we need to try.
The government committing to a nationwide ban on kids using social media.
We know that social media is causing social harm.
Today, new data from a survey of 20,000 Year 10 students finding teens who use TikTok, Reddit and Twitch report lower life satisfaction than those who don't. And while TikTok is associated with the worst life satisfaction for females, for males, it's messaging app Discord.
I spend about 2.5 hours on social media each day.
And that's on YouTube, Snapchat, TikTok.
A bit devastated about social media could be possibly banned.
The government vowing to introduce the landmark ban before the next election, saying it will decide the age after a series of trials testing age verification technology are complete.
We're looking at the range between 14 and 16, and what we're looking at is how you deliver it. Social media has a social responsibility. They're not above everyone else.
But some experts say the move is problematic.
This is a very blunt instrument that's going to potentially exclude children from some very, very helpful supports on social media.
What it could do is breed a lot of complacency amongst parents. Services are under less pressure to design for younger audiences, but children are very inventive and they do find ways to work around these things.
The government's push comes after both Victoria and South Australia moved to introduce their own bans.
We definitively know that social media and its addiction is causing young people across the country a lot of harm.
Young people like Mac Holdsworth, who died by suicide when he was just 17 after he was targeted in a cruel social media sextortion scam.
And I wish I'd known what I know now, and we could have looked after him a bit better. I just wish we could have saved Mac.
Mac's dad, Wayne, has been campaigning for this change ever since.
And Wayne is with us on the desk now. Wayne, thanks for being here. It's been almost a year since you lost your beautiful boy. Do you think laws like this would have saved him?
I think the intent of this law is really honourable. I really do. And it's really based upon looking after our children. And had Mac had this comfort 2 years ago, I am sure it would have made a massive difference in his life. Mm. I really do.
So the age is still kind of being decided. 14 and 16 are kind of getting tossed around as age numbers. What would you think is appropriate?
Yeah, I would think 16 as a minimum. However, I'm a little bit left field and I believe that 14 to start with and then 16, but I believe that people should only get a smartphone when they turn 18.
Oh, wow.
And so not just social media, a smartphone altogether.
That's correct, yeah.
Wow.
So that would then control what's out of control at the moment. It's like the Wild Wild West out there. Mm. And so my view is that we control that. And the announcement overnight is a fantastic announcement, but it is only a start. We have to keep campaigning because we need to do something to save our children. Because I believe that currently the incidence of young people being negatively affected by social media is absolutely... it's sickening. And it's creating all sorts of trouble for parents, not only the people that lose their children, like myself and Emma Mason and Ali, but all those people that have children that are affected by social media exposure. And we hear that they're on it 4 to 6 hours a day after school. Yeah. You know, we hear that kids as young as five, boys as young as five, are addicted to violent porn.
Jeez.
Here in Australia.
And the effect that has just cascades. Yeah. So no one is denying the problem, I don't think. I think everyone accepts there needs to be some kind of response. The criticism is this can't work. It hasn't worked anywhere else where they've tried to do it. In parts of the US, for example, they find a way, they get VPNs or something like that. Do you think that's true, that that's a fair enough criticism?
That's a fair enough criticism because it's fact. But we have to start somewhere. We've got to do something because up until now, nothing's been done. And it's a really good start. I believe that it's a significant time in the country's history, and the announcement last night was significant because we're now doing something. Beforehand, we were doing nothing and it was open slather. Mm. Now at least we're doing something. It will be really difficult to monitor, and Meta will get around it without a doubt, without a problem. But we've got to try to protect our children, because at the moment there's no protection at all, because young kids get on and push I'm over 18 at 5 years of age. Yeah.
And it's helpful for parents as well who need the law behind them to say, no, you're not getting it.
The parents also need to take stock themselves of what they're modelling for their children, which is another discussion as well. But you are talking to a lot of young people in the wake of losing Mac. Mm. What are you hearing from them about social media?
Kate, there's probably two aspects to that question. One is that I do present through smacktalk.com.au sessions around how to educate adults to see the signs in people and to return mental fitness back to the community so that they can help. And the second session that I do is with children at schools. And the feedback that I get from them is that they're quite scared to know that there's predators out there, that they're accessing their data, accessing them and terrorising them.
But they're also more scared to live without social media.
That's correct. Mm. They are. So, you know, it's interesting because we've launched a campaign around Unplug 24 through the smacktalk.com.au, and that's around encouraging people to unplug from social media for 24 hours on the 24th of October, which is Mac's anniversary. And we're encouraging every Australian to unplug 24 to show that we are in control of social media and social media is not in control of us.
Wayne, thank you so much for speaking to us tonight.
Thanks, Sarah.
Appreciate your time.